How's it, everyone? It's Rick from IS Cubed, your eyes and ears on the floor at Exchange 2024. And across the table from me, we have
Murithi Ringji from RAMS.
Welcome, Murithi.
Thank you.
It's good to have you here.
Thank you. Good to be here.
So we know that you're looking after the exhibitor stand for RAMS, but what is it you actually do at RAMS, your actual day job?
My day-to-day job. But even before I get into that, RAMS, it's probably a question around what that means.
A point.
What does it stand for?
Stands for the Integrated Real-Time Asset Management System.
Okay.
If you can tell me what RAMS stands for, I'll give you one of this.
I must try and remember what you told me now. So, Integrated Real-Time Asset Management Solutions.
Right. I think that's good enough. There you go.
So I can have this now?
You can have that. Sponsored.
I can ditch my gray hat with this one. Okay, cool.
This is a limited edition. Yes, they just got hot off the press this morning.
At least you'll be able to find me anywhere.
Right.
Yeah, if you lose me now.
So to answer your question, I am looking after the team that develops the system.
Okay.
That is RAMS. And my typical day involves looking after the system architecture, mentoring, planning, and interfacing with clients. Just to see how we can better solve their problems.
All right. No, great, man. And I'm sure this is not your first conference that you've been at or sort of tech exhibition, but one of the buzzwords that are used quite often is AI, machine learning. Everybody thinks that they can do it and dabble into it, but don't really solve, or they can't really prove the business problem that it can solve. So I'm sure that there's a critical pain point that RAMS does solve for businesses out there. Can you maybe just give us an example of one pain point that you know that you can solve with RAMS?
Right. So one of the biggest challenges that we see repeating itself is we have people who spend a lot of the time in the office, obviously dealing with the day-to-day problems. Some of these problems are just about a day or a week away from solving. Some of these problems require a longer period of time to resolve. The problem is that these problems center around assets that are in the field, and they rarely have an opportunity to actually see these assets on a day-to-day basis.
Yeah.
So we find that there's a gap between what they talk about in the office and what's actually happening in the field. That's the problem that we're trying to solve, so that there's a synergy between what is said in the office and what is actually happening to the asset with an asset in the field.
Yeah, so unfortunately, we haven't invented teleportation yet.
Right.
So we can't do that. So that's the gap that you're for.
That's right. That's a gap that we feel. You typically find in extremely complicated environments, you know, when as a business becomes bigger and their problems become more complicated, it just becomes that more difficult to track when assets are changing, when assets become obsolete, when assets go out of their support life cycles, when assets no longer speak to the rest of your ecosystem.
Mm-hmm.
And this is about closing the gap between the user of that asset and the asset itself, because you do not want to be behind the curve when something goes wrong. You want to preempt a problem before it happens and take the necessary action. And of course, you would agree with me that that comes at a much reduced cost to the client.
No, 100%. It's always better to have that preventive maintenance.
That's right.
100%. No, good, man. It's awesome catching up with you.
Thank you.
And for everyone watching, we hope to see you at the RAMS stand.
Yeah.
And remember, if you know what RAMS stands for, you're going to get a free hat as well.
That's right.